Hi, everyone. So good to see you all. Wow, this is great. This is great. So, it's not on your program, but as Gabrielle said, we do open each monthly jam session with a nod to the great Louis Armstrong by doing a tune that he recorded. It's usually one that's a little out of the ordinary, maybe not as well known as Wonderful World. And we're going to do that tonight with a tune called A Kiss to Build Your Dream On. Which is written by Kalmar, Ruby, and Hammerson. There was one other thing I wanted to say, that by the oddest of chances, when we were going over our calendars together, and there were many calendars to consider, Flushing's calendar and all the people in the house band, the only date that we all could make this concert was August 4th, which happens, by the oddest of coincidences, to be the real birthday of Louis Armstrong. We do this little tribute to Louis Armstrong as in partly in thanks to the Louis Armstrong Educational Foundation, which supports our jams, and we are very happy about that. So here's the tune. So, let's welcome to the bandstand. Glen Lowe on drums. In the tune, Take Five. Okay, so two more things about this is that you're also being joined by guitarist Keith Jordan on this tune. And secondly, Glen has a small tale, true story to tell about, well, something very relevant.
Thank everyone for coming out and supporting live music, because we really appreciate it. We as musicians and artists really appreciate you coming out. You know, as I always like to say, there's lots of schools where we can go, you know, Berkeley and then Manhattan School of Music and Juilliard, to become educated players. There are not a lot of places where you can go to become an educated listener. So that means that you all have taken the time and effort to educate yourselves and listen, and we appreciate it. Just want to say that, and it's very important for the young people too. I just have a very quick story. Today is Louis Armstrong's birthday, and I had an opportunity to meet Mr. Armstrong when I was a young kid. We lived on 108th Street, Mr. Armstrong lived on 107th Street. So I went over to the supermarket, and my mother met his wife and said, "Oh, I'd like to bring Glen over to meet Mr. Armstrong," you know? And I was about 7, 8 years old, and I knew sort of who he was. I'd seen him kind of on TV. And we went over to the house, you know what I mean? I was 8. He wasn't Batman, but, you know, I knew he was important. I knew he was, you know, he was on TV. In the 60s, if you're on TV, that means you're really somebody.
Yeah.
Not anymore. So anyway, we go into the house, and I highly recommend that you go take the tour and go over to Mr. Armstrong's house. It's really nice. It's preserved very well. We go up there, and my mother and I walk into the room, and Mr. Armstrong is behind his desk, and it's a beautiful white carpet. I always remember that. And he's sitting there, and his smile, that famous smile, you know. And my mother says, "Oh, Mr. Armstrong, this is Glen. This is my son. He just started playing piano, and I had just started taking guitar lessons." So mom says, "Yeah, Mr. Armstrong, my son, he just started playing piano," and I, being a little wise guy, said, "No, Mom, I started guitar. Mr. Armstrong looked right at me, and he smiled, and he said, "Go on, boy." Just like that. And I'm not going to say that, you know, I wouldn't be here if it hadn't been for that, but just think of, you know, the amount of encouragement, you know, and goodwill that he imparted to me as a young child. You know, this man, this great man, took the time to, you know, listen to what I had to say. He encouraged me, you know, and, you know, it's so important, you know, to do that with young people, people like young Matthew Jordan, who I know was out there, Buddy Drummer. And, you know, he made such an impression on me, and it's lasted. I've had a chance to meet and play with some great artists, but I will never forget that. So, thank you. Sometimes people say, "Hey, you know, you tell people, yeah, I've got Neil Armstrong," and they're like, "Shit, right." You know, they act like you're talking about alien abduction or something. But he was nice enough to give me this nice to Glen, so I was really there. This is, it's been in this frame so long that it's stuck to the glass. I'm not taking it out. I'm not taking it out. So, thank you.
Okay.
Take Five, written by Paul Desmond, recorded by the Dave Brubeck Trio, Group. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Next, we have a very outstanding composer, arranger, and baritone saxophonist. She's really, she surprises us all the time with new compositions. Not easy, I should add. Let's have a big welcome for Sarah Turkiew.
Thank you.
And that is called Yes, I Can. And she certainly can. Next is a beautiful piece, which I especially love, called Never Let Me Go, which is performed by Sharif Kales. In the meantime, let me introduce the band. You already know about the wonderful Joe Vincent Tranchina. Eric Lemon, the marvelous Eric Lemon on bass. And the incomparable Scott Neumann on drums. Now let's have a big welcome for Sharif Kales. Thank you. Sharif Kales. Sharif Kales. We also have many wonderful vocalists who come to the jams every month.
Yeah.
And among them is this very special woman. Her name is Iga Mrozek, and she's going to do Lullaby of Birdland. going to play the beautiful piece, Janine. We are almost running on schedule. Very close. Which is good, because if we run on schedule, then you're going to hear each of these performers again after the break on a different tune.
Good evening. I'm going to tell you one thing real quick. Pay attention. Yeah. Tell you something real quick, because we're on time. Carol's looking at me right now. We got to go. That's my stool. I bought it for $10 20 years ago. Thank you.
by wonderful vocalists. You would love him, Frank Robinson. See you next time.
I see so many beautiful souls out here. This is nice. Listen, today I'm going to take the liberty to reinvent a lyric that Mr. Gershwin wrote for Summertime. I want to bring it up today a bit. So I hope you enjoy.
Listed as number 16, his own original, The Song of Night. And then, if time permits, he will play the other selection after the break. So, Jose Luis Armengot, The Song of Night. with the wonderful Victor Acosta playing a piece by Thelonious Monk, the Bolivar Blues. For an intermission, powder room, and the rest of it. So I think that if in your mind's eye, if you could move that intermission sign right up between numbers 8 and 9, take a little break now, and then we'll reconvene, beginning with Gary Davis, right after the break. Thank you very much. So let's have a big hand for Gary.
And now the purple dusk of twilight time steals across the meadows of my heart. High up in the sky, the little stars climb, reminding me that we are far apart. You wander down the lane, following, leaving me a song that cannot die. Love is just the stardust of yesterday. The memory of days gone by. Sometimes I'll wonder why I stand the lonely night. And I am once again with you. When our love was new, and each kiss an inspiration. Long ago, now my consolation is in the star na 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 dust of a song beside a garden wall when the stars were bright. His fairy tale of paradise where roses bloom. Though I dream in vain, forever in my heart you will remain. That star just melody, the memory of love's refrain.
And now, Mamoru, Mamoru Tashiro. Thank you.
Thank you.
You have the lyrics, I don't know if you'll be able to see them. Maybe you can turn the house lights up a little, but what a wonderful world. And we will be led by our three singers, alternating verses.
White, bright, blessed day, and the
to myself. What a wonderful world.
They ain't so wonderful either. But how about listening to old pops for a minute? Seems to me it ain't the world that's so bad, but what we are doing to it. And all I'm saying is, see what a wonderful world it would be if only we'd give it a chance. Love, baby, love. That's the secret. Yeah. If lots more of us loved each other, we'd solve lots more problems. And man, this world would be a guesser.